Mammoth Hot Springs. Mammoth Hot Springs differs from all other Yellowstone geothermal features not only because of its immense size, but also its chemistry. Most of Yellowstone basement rock is rich in silica, being either solidified ash or rhyolite lava flows. But here, 20 miles north of the caldera's boundary, the bedrock is predominantly limestone. Limestone dissolves in superheated water much more readily than silica. When limestone's supersaturated water cools, it deposits travertine. Where sinter deposits grow only a few millimeters per year, these travertine terraces expand up to 2 feet per year. The Mammoth Hot Springs adds 2 tons of new rock to its mountainous bulk every single day. The upper portion of the hot spring can be viewed from a 1.5 mile one-way driving loop. After turning onto the upper terrace drive, skip the overlook parking lot. In this case, it's better to save the best for last. Continue around the drive to see the colorful Orange Spring Mound and Angel Terrace, where a sudden resurgence in 1985 caused this spring, like a colossal amoeba, to slowly engulf the surrounding forest. Now, on your second lap around Upper Terrace Drive, stop at the overlook and explore the network of boardwalks that crisscross the terraces. Take the trail on the right to see Canary Spring. Alternatively, the left-hand trail leads past New Blue Spring to Minerva Terrace, where the ornate layers of travertine look as if a frustrated baker made a landfill of collapsed layer cakes. At the base of the lower terrace is Liberty Cap and Pallet Spring. Liberty Cap is the 37-foot-tall core of an ancient spring. Fresh limestone drips over the yellow-orange bacterial mats of Pallet Spring like the sticky glaze on a massive bundt cake. Pallet Spring is so active that the rapid growth of this glacier of stone has closed and will inevitably bury a section of the boardwalk. Amazingly, the outflow from these springs is an underground river that resurfaces between the towns of Mammoth, Wyoming and Gardner, Montana, near the 45th parallel, halfway between the equator and the North Pole. It merges with the Gardner River, and only where the two rivers combine is it cooled enough to be enjoyed as a large natural hot tub.